Hey coach, welcome back. My name is Dr Stacey Emmonds and I'm a senior lecturer in sports coaching at Leeds Beckett University. I'm also an athletic development coach for the English Football Association and the England Women's Rugby League national team. The previous video summarised how children develop from a social perspective. This video will outline the various stages of physical development that children go through, explore some important issues related to the process of physical maturation, and draw some key implications for coaches. Before we start, some key terms that are important to understand include what we mean by the terms youth, children, and adolescents. By children, we mean 2 to 10 years of age in girls and 2 to 11 years in boys. By adolescents, we mean the period from approximately 11 to 19 in girls and 12 to 19 in boys. And finally, by youth, we mean children and adolescents. Please note that adolescence is more difficult to define due to maturation. Other key terms to be aware of include growth, maturation, and development. Okay, so what is growth? Growth is an increase in the size of the body and its parts and includes changes in height, body mass, fat, and the organs. There are 4 main types of growth which occur in the body. These are 1, general growth. This includes changes in the size of the body and its parts and includes areas such as height and heart size. 2, neural growth. This relates to changes in the size of the head and the brain. 3, genital growth. This refers to changes in the reproductive organs. And 4, lymphoid growth. This is related to the changes in the lymphoid system, such as the glands, the appendix, and the tonsils. The main 2 types of growth we'll focus upon here are general growth and neural growth. General growth reflects the external, e.g. height, and internal, heart and lungs, growth that occurs in the body. For a coach, the 2 most important types are height and mass. Height and mass increase rapidly in the first few years of life and then they plateau off. There's then a steady period of growth until the growth spurt, which we'll focus upon later. Have a look at the growth charts for typical sizes of boys and girls. It's very important, however, to be aware of the differences in size of boys and girls of the same age. For example, an 8-year-old girl can normally vary between 115 and 151 centimetres, and a boy can vary between 120 to 152 centimetres. In addition, children do develop slightly differently depending on their gender, but there's more variation amongst girls and boys than there is between them. Very importantly, every child is unique and will develop at his or her own pace. Therefore, it is recommended that a child's growth is monitored approximately every 3 months. In the prepubertal period until 9 to 10 years of age, gender differences are relatively small. However, around the age of 10 or 11, girls will generally experience a growth spurt before boys do and are thus taller. This is due to the earlier onset of puberty in girls. However, by the age of 14 or 15, boys have usually outgrown girls. This accelerated period of growth that children experience with the onset of puberty is often referred to as the growth spurt, and will have an impact upon the physical capabilities of participants within your session. During this accelerated period of growth, growth occurs distal to proximal. This means that hands and feet grow before the torso, which results in youth having relatively long legs, which can impact upon their physical capabilities, such as motor coordination and spatial awareness. Therefore, children may appear clumsy and uncoordinated in their movements. We must consider this when designing activities within our sessions and may even need to retrain and reinforce some of the fundamental movement skills such as a squat, a lunge, skipping, running, which children will have first learned at a young age. Let's now move on to neural growth. Neural growth relates to growth of the head and the brain. You may have noticed that young children have relatively large heads. By the age of 8, the brain and head is approximately 90% of its adult size. This affects their balance and needs to be considered within your coaching. For example, this means children are able to control proximal parts of the body and bigger muscle groups earlier than distal and smaller muscle groups. For example, they will be able to kick, hit, or throw for distance, but less for placement, meaning that within your coaching, an emphasis should be placed on gross motor skill development before fine motor skill development. What this neural growth does allow is for the development of fundamental movement skills at these childhood years. See section 4.1 for more information in this area. Now that we understand growth a bit better, let's talk about maturation. This is important because growth is quite consistent and steady until we approach the maturity or growth spurt period. Maturation is the progress towards the adult state. There are two key stages to maturation. The first one is timing. Timing is the age when specific maturational events occur. For example, age of pubic hair appearance or age at maximum growth in height. The second one is tempo. Tempo is the rate at which maturation progresses. In other words, how quick or how slow someone passes through maturation. During the growth spurt, there are two key stages, peak height velocity and peak weight velocity. Peak height velocity refers to the maximum velocity of growth in stature and has been used as a key marker in relation to the developments in performance during this period. By contrast, peak weight velocity is a phase of development characterized by rapid increases in muscle mass as a result of increasing sex hormone concentrations. As we said earlier, girls generally go through their growth spurt around the ages of 11 to 12, while boys experience a growth spurt slightly later, around the ages of 13 to 14 years. It's after this growth spurt that we start to see significant differences in the physical capabilities of boys and girls. This is because of the changes in the body that occur during this period. Boys tend to have an increase in lean muscle mass due to the increase in the hormone testosterone, while girls generally experience an increase in fat mass due to the increase in female hormones, progesterone and estrogen. All in all, these accelerated periods of growth will impact upon children's coordination and spatial awareness. Therefore, they may appear clumsy and awkward in their movement. We also often see considerable variation in the growth and maturation rates among participants, with use of the same chronological age differing dramatically in their biological maturity. Consequently, this means we may have children with very different physical capabilities within the same group when coaching. We therefore need to consider how we may adapt our sessions to challenge both the early and the late maturer. So what are the key take-home messages for you to consider in your coaching? One, height and mass increases rapidly in the first years of life and then plateaus off. There is then a steady period of growth until the growth spurt. During this period, children are ready to learn fundamental movement skills, and these should be emphasized within your coaching sessions. Two, children do develop slightly differently depending on their gender, but there's more variation amongst girls and boys than there is between them. It is recommended growth is monitored approximately every 3 months, so you can adapt your training accordingly. Three, with the onset of puberty, children experience a growth spurt, which may make them appear clumsy and uncoordinated in their movements, referred to as adolescent awkwardness. And finally, four, during the growth spurt, we may need to retrain and reinforce some of the fundamental movement skills, such as a squat, lunge, skips, and running, which children will have first learned at a young age but seem to lose at this point. Now it's time for you to think about how this plays out in your coaching context. Please move on to the reflective activities and remember to download the study guide for further information. See you soon.